Welcome to This Week in the Index. I'm your host, Grayson Brulte. This Week in the Index was designed to highlight the Road to Autonomy Index. The Road to Autonomy Index, comprised of 38 publicly traded companies, is a high-definition lens into the emerging world of autonomous vehicles. The Road to Autonomy Index is the world's first and only pure-play index designed to measure the performance of the autonomous vehicle ecosystem. And companies have identified autonomy as a key component of their growth strategies. For the week of June 5th, the Road to Autonomy Index returned 4.33%. The S&P 500 returned 2.58%. The NASDAQ 100 returned 3.82%. The Road to Autonomy Index this week outperformed the S&P 500 by 1.75%. This week, the Road to Autonomy Index outperformed the NASDAQ 100 by 0.51%. The top-performing stocks in the Road to Autonomy Index this week were Toyota, which returned 12.89%. The gain in Toyota stock was driven by their newly announced EV strategy. Toyota's coming in the electric vehicle industry. Be interesting to see what happens. Followed by NVIDIA, which returned 10.82%, and John Deere, which returned 7.74%. While these stocks perform well, they are just three of the 38 publicly traded companies that are components of the Road to Autonomy Index. News and opinion drives the market, and this week in autonomy, there were some developments. Bloomberg Intelligence is forecasting that John Deere, a Road to Autonomy Index component, will achieve free cash flow that could exceed $8 billion by the end of the year. The forecast is driven by Deere's technology advantage. Their machines are becoming autonomous. They're driving free cash flow for Deere. Autonomous tractors, after all, they're the future, and they'll be great for both farmers and investors. It's not just farming where autonomy will have a meaningful impact, it's the global economy. Autonomy will impact every aspect of society and the global economy. In the future, the advancements in autonomy will help to usher in the autonomy economy. This is why companies around the world are investing billions upon billions of dollars in autonomy. While companies are investing billions of dollars in autonomy, there's a select minority, small group of individuals who, for whatever reason, want to see autonomy fail. To achieve their outlandish goals, these individuals are acting in a manner that's reprehensible. Frankly, it's disgusting, as they are twisting the facts to fit their narrative, to move their agenda forward. This week, it was reported widely on social media that a cruise vehicle blocked an intersection in San Francisco, blocking police and fire from responding to an incident. Then came the tweets. Aaron Peskin, San Francisco Supervisor District 3, tweeted the following, and quote, "This is not the first time a Cruise or a Waymo AV has impeded emergency first responders, and SF continues to have grave concerns with CPUC's hastily decision to allow a massive ramp up on our streets." Continuing not to understand the situation, the tweets kept going. Jackie Fiedler, who's running for San Francisco Supervisor candidate, running for a seat, she tweeted, and I quote, "A Waymo car stopped in the way of emergency personnel who seemed to be responding to the 24th Street shooting or another emergency, absolutely infiltrating. Gavin Newsom, get your CPUC appointments to get these things off the streets now." The vehicle in question, it was not a Waymo vehicle, it was a Cruise vehicle. There goes the agenda. In a follow-up tweet clarifying her first tweet, Ms. Fiedler tweeted the following, "Correction, it's a Cruise car. They should both be taken off the streets, IMO." End quote. Turns out both tweets, factually incorrect, trying to push an agenda. In an emailed statement to NBC News on Wednesday, June 14th, the San Francisco Police Department stated the following, and I quote, "The autonomous vehicle did not delay police, fire, or other emergency personnel with our arrival or departure from the scene. Furthermore, it did not interfere with our investigation into the shooting incident." End quote. No incident. The sad part is there's dialogue like this every day in San Francisco. The police had to come out and clarify it wasn't the AV. Cruise and Waymo, they're building the future. They're helping to usher in the autonomy economy, and frankly, San Francisco, they should be proud to have them there. There was exciting news in San Francisco this week. Cruise tests the Cruise Origin, their bespoke vehicle, on the public roads for the first time in history. This is a major, major milestone. The fact that the vehicle is currently testing on public roads is remarkable. This has been achieved because of the technological breakthroughs that both GM, a Road to Autonomy Index component company, and Cruise have been able to achieve. Paul Jacobson, chief financial officer at GM, recently stated that the breakthroughs have been achieved because Cruise has one of the most sophisticated AI platforms and autonomous driving that exist anywhere. The Cruise platforms allowed them to eclipse 1 million miles earlier this year, and then 90 days later, they eclipsed 2 million miles. Driven fully autonomous on public roads. Fully autonomous on public roads. Yet we rarely hear about all the positive news outside the autonomous vehicle industry. As a small minority, want autonomy to fail. They want the technology to fail. Newsflash, autonomy will not fail. Autonomy will succeed, and it will usher in the autonomy economy. In a report from RBC Capital this week, analyst Tom Naran stated that 70% of Tesla's revenue could come from robo-taxis. During an appearance at the Viva Tech Conference in Paris, France on Friday, June 16th, Mr. Elon Musk stated the following on stage. The value of the company is primarily on the basis of autonomy. Tesla Road to Autonomy Index Company continues to push autonomy forward through the development of full self-driving, the eventual licensing of their full self-driving technology. They will license it. You watch. Tesla ushered in electric vehicles, and now they're working to usher in autonomous vehicles. It's very clear. In the report, Mr. Naran stated the following. We believe that robo-taxis and autonomous vehicles in general could potentially transform society more than anything else in our lifetimes. They could save millions of lives and trillions of hours. Autonomous vehicles will transform society, and they will create massive, massive economic and investment opportunities. During his time in Paris, Mr. Musk had lunch with Mr. Bernard Arnault, chairman and CEO of LVMH at LVMH's Cheval Blanc Hotel. Perhaps an autonomous Louis Vuitton vehicle powered by Tesla's in the works after all. We shall wait and see. We think LV is going to do something. As the autonomous vehicle industry and ecosystem matures, the Road to Autonomy Index will evolve. But at no time can the index have more than 45 component companies. For a company to be considered for the index, they must be publicly traded on a recognized exchange for 365 days. Have a minimum market capitalization of US $2 billion for 90 days prior to the one-year anniversary of their debut as a public company. In addition to having a 90-day daily average volume of $500,000 or greater, autonomy is a business, and there's an index to track its performance. The autonomy economy is coming. Be sure to follow the Road to Autonomy Index, ticker Autonomy, on your favorite finance app. Again, it's ticker Autonomy, AUTONOMY. Be sure to join us again next Sunday for the latest installment of the Road to Autonomy's This Week in the Index. The future is bright, the future is autonomous, and the future is a thriving autonomous vehicle ecosystem.